Hi everyone!
We just wanted to make this video as a huge thank you for the 100,000 subscribers.
That's a lot.
It seriously
That's
is.
More than 10.
Yeah. It takes some channels like 8 months to get 100,000. Took us like 8 years to get 100,000.
We won't talk about that. Who's counting?
We don't hold any grudges or anything.
But we wanted to do something like almost like a Draw My Life, but under the circumstances that I can't draw.
I can't draw.
I can draw, but I'm lazy.
Yeah, and therefore we decided we'd just talk about our lives instead. Our channel actually kind of started where I was the new kid in school. I came out of a okay scenario, but I wanted to try something new and different. And as school went on, I started to try to make friends, you know, new kid, and I ran into this guy.
And you know, when you go through like middle school and high school, you kind of, you know, can cycle through friend groups, drama, and all that kind of stuff. And it so happened that you and I crossed paths and we decided, you know, hey, this guy's kind of weird, I'm kind of weird.
Let's just go be weird over there.
Together, yeah.
So you've
regretted it ever since.
But at the high school, I overheard from my older sister that there was this segment where we had a TV program where at some point during the TV program, the producer would hand two kids a video camera and said, go do something, make something fun. And I thought it'd be a really cool idea, and I thought that, you know, my new weird friend
and
would
then
be...
kind of at the time, I was starting to get more into video production. I went to a couple of video production camps. I was getting an interest in editing and, you know, doing camera work and stuff, and I wanted some kind of outlet to, you know, work on that kind of stuff and learn new things.
And for me, I was very theatrical growing up, if you can't tell by my awesome acting. Questionable.
Acting.
Awesome. Acting. Yeah. But a lot of what we do on the channel really pushed me to try to do something new, and I brought this up to Brian. I'm like, hey, I think this might be a fun idea. And we were both eighth graders staring at one another going, great!
What do we do now?
So we decided, you know what? YouTube was up and coming. It was a brand new platform. We decided, why not? Let's try it.
Yeah.
And then we came up with TV Madness.
Oh boy, that aged well, didn't it?
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Hi, Billy Mays here with the greatest future next product, the Mystical Cleaner.
Hi, Brian, I'm gonna go cross the road. Be back, this is boring.
But, you know, at the same time, even though you look back at it now, you know, obviously the quality is still low, we still had, like, such a blast making it.
And at the
time, it was really impressive that we were able to, you know, put, like, a video together, like, something like that. It was a fun thing to do together, and we did that, and we did a few other videos. Some didn't even make it onto the channel. We just were, you know, every weekend or so, we would get together and film something fun.
So a lot of our channel, we tried different things, you know, with a lot of YouTube. We try to find things that stick. Some things are immediate sell, other things take a while, and ours definitely did.
Yeah.
But it was one of those things where Brian and I went to different colleges, and he posted Pokemon Logic. And both of us have a huge fascination with video games, and so we usually like to make pokes and prods at some things, but when they did Pokemon Logic, we saw one YouTube commenter, and whoever that YouTube commenter is, we thank you to this day.
Thank you.
Because I still remember reading, this video is so great, we're going to put it on the number one Pokemon fan site. And I forget how big of a jump it was, but our video went from 200 views to 20,000 views.
And at this time, this was just like something like, oh my goodness.
For us, that was huge.
What? This is crazy. We have maybe like 500 subscribers at the time.
I think half of them were like my mom and your dad.
And then all my friends from college were just like, oh my gosh, your channel is so cool. I want to be part of this. I want to be a part of this, you know? And Yeah, I mean, it was really cool. And then eventually, you know, when we came home for like summer breaks and winter breaks, Joe and I would get together and we'd make some more videos kind of based off of those kind of video game logic in real life. And then when we did the Zelda logic in real life in 2013, that's when Brandon joined us.
Hi. Yeah. I was one of those friends where it's like, I want to be a part of this, but I stuck, unfortunately. I came in and they're like, hey, we need you to stand in this corner with your long hair and a thermal, like my edgy high school self, because they were in college. They're 2 years older than I am, so they were in college and I was in high school, and they brought me on during their break to fill this role, and I was literally just standing there. It's the first time I was ever on camera. And I had a blast standing in a corner staring at Link smashing my pots.
You stood there better than any other actor I could ever imagine.
I am the perfect stander. The
perfect stander.
But yeah, that's how I was introduced to the channel, and from there it was kind of like they called me for a lot of shoots because I was really reliable to stand in corners.
Yeah. And, he was reliable.
And he still...
The word was.
Was.
But as the channel grew, we tried and we had people cycle in and out, high school friends, college friends, but it got to the point where a lot of our logics were the bigger feature, and out of nowhere, once again, it took off.
It took off, you know, right around the time we were starting to do the Epic Project. I don't know if any of you guys remember that.
I do.
I remember that.
One of our first like original kind of pieces we did one summer. Around that time, there was another Pokemon logic that we did that also sparked a lot of attention on the Pokemon fan site. And then from that, a bunch of viewers who watched that one watched a whole bunch of our other videos. And that summer was actually really productive. We shot maybe from a couple thousand to almost 10,000. Subscribers, and that's kind of really when things started taking off. You know, a couple more years of college went by. It was a little tough sometimes because we're getting really involved in our studies. At least I was. You know, I went to film school, so I had a lot on my plate to do. I was editing a lot of films in film school, and you know, on breaks and stuff like that, we would come together. Some of my friends from college would come together and make some films too, but you know, the consistency was tough, but every once in a while, there always was this video that stood out. You know, one would get like a whole bunch of views from one site, another would get another bunch of views. And out of nowhere, you know, it was crazy because this one video that we made in 2013, one of our first videos that we made in our Logic series, obviously it's the most popular Nintendo series out there, Super Mario Logic. It just completely blew up out of nowhere, and it was just like, starting to get like 1 million views, 2 million views, 3 million views.
Like we were one of those videos that when you see seven figures under a video, that was us. It's like, guys, it's just like, that's us.
There are other channels with millions of subscribers that their most viewed video has less views than our most viewed video. Which is awesome insane to think about.
And it's one of those things that came back to bite me because, if you haven't seen the video, I dressed up in a obviously awkward Princess Peach dress. Because no other actor showed up for that day.
This was before my time, so.
This was before Brandon.
Yeah.
It was one of those moments where Brian looked at me and he's like, I am not getting in that
dress. I'm not getting in it.
So I said, I'll get into it on the hope that this video does not get multiple views.
And then
23 million people later changed that. Then after Mario Logic, we did a lot of other videos such as Zelda Logic, or Smash Brothers Logic, which initially we thought, this will be fun, let's talk about it. It's still a surprise to see just the passion behind what people think is really good versus okay, just to see how those videos also took off. And some of the videos that we do on this channel, I still love to watch because they're great projects that all three of us contributed to.
Yeah, even though those were made like years and years ago, they're always some of my favorite ones to watch on the channel. Even though we had such a smaller camera at the time, we barely had any equipment and stuff.
No scripts.
No,
that's still true.
We literally went outside and we're like, so what would be funny? Brain kissing.
It's a fun experience, you know, because like, especially I know for myself, being at film school and working in film, everything, you know, gets really serious at times when you're working on this stuff. Everything's really thought out and really everything's, all the details are put into place. And just to be able to go out with the camera and just like have fun with this is just such a relief. Sometimes.
We were just literally as silly as we wanted to be. Our inner children came out and we said, what would be stupid funny? And was the videos and that came out.
And that's the glory of YouTube. Yeah. Absolutely, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And what I think was the crowning masterpiece was just being able to come at it from a completely different angle, because both of us, we don't have film degrees, but we still really enjoy using YouTube as a creative outlet. And so it's always fun to change things up from a different perspective in both film perspectives and non-film perspectives alike. You know. And what kind of brought all three of us together as a team was a clutch move by Brandon.
Back in the day, after I graduated high school, I got a job at GameStop because we don't make money off of the channel. The channel makes money and the money goes into the production of the channel, but none of us take money out of that for ourselves. So we all had to get jobs and progress on with our lives and continue to do the channel at the same time. I got a job at GameStop, and probably like a year and a half after I started working there, I ran into an awesome guy named Ryan Schott, who Ryan shot at the time, just started this new company called Screenwave Media. And what that company is, it's a YouTube MCN that we ended up partnering with, and they were local and they allowed us to come and film in their studio and use their equipment.
In fact, we're here right now.
All this stuff is not ours. So, except the camera and whatever. But
my shirt.
That's ours. Yeah, our clothes are ours, yes. I hope.
Sponsored.
This isn't mine.
Are you leasing it?
Brian!
they really helped us come up with good strategies on how to grow the channel, as well as let us use their equipment and their space. And it really took our production level from the kids in college just making whatever to the kids in college making whatever with a little bit of a higher production quality.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
And since then, after partnering with them, I ended up getting a job here at Screenwave, so it's made things a lot easier because I understand the back end of YouTube so much more that I work with it daily, so
yeah.
It's helped with the channel and keep the consistency up and everything like that, and we have free reign to the offices now. And I know as of right now, because of a MatPat video and other things, there's a lot of negative connotation on MCNs. And I have a little bit of a biased opinion because I work for one, but outside of that, as being a channel on the network way before I even started working for them, if you find a good MCN, they're gonna help you. If they take your money and don't talk to you, then it's not worth it. But that's the thing about Screenwave is they took us out to dinner. We were making no money for them. They took us out to dinner. They wanted to talk to us. They wanted to engage in a personal relationship with us, and they weren't just sitting there stealing our money for the heck of it, because Ryan, the president of the company, the one that I met at GameStop, doesn't believe in that. So he's very big on making sure the channels have the personal connection, and that's why we ended up going with them and leaving our old network, which we won't mention, but...
And yeah. Honestly, it's one of those things that really has helped all of us, and it's really fostered some awesome relationships where we were able to expand and grow and meet just so many awesome new people. And being able to also go see you guys at too many games or packs, where we're able to go and really meet other people who show gratitude for the channel that we're always eternally grateful for. And it's guys like you and ladies like you and everyone else out there like you that watches this channel that really inspires us to keep doing our best.
We, like I said earlier, we don't make any profit on this channel. We're doing it for fun and we're doing it for the audience, so... We could stop the channel at any point in time and it wouldn't impact our lives at all, but that's we're doing it because it's what we like to do.
Absolutely.
So yep. We're really doing this for you guys, and that's why we continue to do it. So,
and then 100,000 subscribers is a milestone, but it's really just a stepping stone and our path to wherever this takes us. We want to just continue doing this until as long as we can, and
until I have to walk around with a cane with gray hair going, "You kids, get off my lawn!" For the three of us, it's been an honor, and it's still going to be an honor to be able to make these videos for you guys, because a lot of what we do with our content is try to give you guys genuine fun videos that we think, oh, what if we did this? Or, oh my gosh, what if this were to happen?
What if this game was applied to real life? Exactly. How would that impact our lives?
Exactly.
This is essentially our biggest thank you we could ever ask for. To our patrons, you guys are phenomenal. For those that are not patrons, totally signed up to be those.
Not mandatory,
optional. We can't tell you what to do.
You don't have to give us your money, but we like money, so.
But
Brian's tripod is broken. So
it's true.
Camera falls. Yeah.
Thank you. You guys are amazing. All 100,000 plus, welcome to the CKCU. The CK Cinematic Universe.
copyright strike. Channel deleted.
But nonetheless, we can't thank you all enough. And the only thing we ask is that you guys please continue to enjoy the content that we produce. And thank you guys for enjoying the ride so far. Let's get to 1,000,000!
And to everybody that's watched this far, and to everybody that's asked, Minecraft Logic is filmed, but you will never see it.
Exactly.
That's our draw my life without the drawing, so it's just my life.
It's our lives, just connected on a gray couch.
Yep.
So we'll
this is probably how it's going to end too, eventually. I'll be sitting here on a gray couch in front of a camera saying, well, guys, it was a good run. But today's not that day, and we will keep going.
We'll see you guys next week for the next episode of Infinity Wall.
I'm excited. That being said,
bye, everyone.
So what happens next week on Infinity Wall? I don't even know, though.